some artists have the palette is a famous palette of Rembrandt, or the famous brushes of this or this other artist. In his case, for me, the most unique tool that he uses is his chair. He has a child chair that he uses for painting, but he cannot sit anywhere else. It needs to be his chair, and he has fixed it so many times already, because he's a little one and he's heavy and he's big and he's growing, and the chair looks every time smaller. But he cannot work without it. We can change the palette, we can change the color, we can change the light, whatever, but the chair, it needs to be there. Otherwise, he cannot work. When we married, he promised to make for me 1,000 paintings. And he's working on that. Every painting has a number in the back and my name of these 1,000 paintings he promised me. And I am sure that by the time he finished the painting 1,000, he will be known all over United States and Europe. And I am very, very excited, just waiting the moment. It will take years. It will take maybe 5 years, maybe 8, 10 years, I don't know. But I'm completely sure, and my dream is one day to reunite some of those paintings that would be all over the world, to put them in a special place for a show.
My instincts tell me, and they did immediately, that this is a very talented person that ought to have prominence, and I believe is going to have prominence. We think he's going to become a significant influence in Southwestern art, and that people ought to investigate him for two reasons, frankly, because his art is beautiful, and for investment purposes, we think it's going to be a whole lot more valuable in the future.
I've been to Russia 34 times, and I've written 2 books on the subject. I've been in the studios of 400 artists. I've seen literally tens of thousands of Russian paintings throughout the 20th century. His major work is so superlative in a technical sense, and it deals with objects of real life in such a visual sense that they tend to have value that I think will be appreciated across the generations. It's kind of based and rooted in tradition. And so I think that he will continue to have an audience, both critically and in a popular sense, for centuries.
He paints for the right reasons. He's not just out there, well, what's selling, you know, looking around and seeing, he just loves to paint and will continue to do a good job. He just, he's a hard worker and he's just really driven. And I relate to guys like that, and I like it.
Sasha is a jewel. It's not very often that you come across a talent and an artist like that. I know that Sasha will be with this gallery until the gallery closes its doors or Sasha has stopped painting.
I mean, there's no reason why, like those moccasins he just finished, that they aren't selling for $150,000. But I think anything that you have of his is someday going to be worth a lot of money. I can honestly say in my heart, I've never known a better artist. I mean, personally, for this day and age, I don't think anybody can surpass him.